What up, y'all? It's DJ AlphaTyler back again with another Mega Monday reaction. And if y'all are new around here, don't know how Mega Monday rolls, we take the top artists on the channel that y'all keep coming back for over and over and over again, and we hit up, you know, a ton of their videos. And up until now, I haven't really had a cap on how many I'm gonna hit up, but I am gonna change that just because it's been really hard, specifically for Mondays, to make sure that I'm getting all the content. So I'm gonna put a limit on how many weeks in a row somebody can be in this top spot. And it's gonna be four, because we go back 4 weeks to check it out anyway. 4 weeks in a row is the cap. You gotta at least take a week off, and then you come back next week if you're still on the list. We're also only going to do, on any given day, a maximum of something like 8 videos. I don't know. We just can't get out of control with like 10, 12 videos every day. So, enjoy this huge haul today. They're still going to be big drops. I don't know another channel that's dropping, you know, 8, 10, 12 videos a day. So, you know, we kind of got out of control, right? I mean, but it ain't a bad thing. I'm going to have a new channel banner probably up on Sunday. With the new channel schedule, we are shifting some things around to make sure that I got some time to get some new content, because y'all keep blasting me for tons of new content, and I keep pushing it aside, and we keep coming back. And I enjoy these reactions, but I'm trying to broaden some horizons. You know, we need to check out some new things here and there. Anyway, it's Mega Monday. Y'all are here to see reactions to the hottest names on the channel. And up front, how can we ignore Eskimo Callboy? Y'all keep telling me the scene is where we need to go, featuring Fronz. I think it's Fronz. We checking out the scene featuring Fronz, Eskimo Callboy. I love Eskimo Callboy, so I know they're about to bring it. Let's get it. What y'all got me watching? Hang on. Everybody get the fuck up! Woo! Y'all, anybody listening to this, like, with the instrumentals, with the guitars and everything, any of y'all think about, like, maybe Korn? Maybe not, you know, Follow the Leader Korn, but some kind of, like, shades of Korn are in there. And then with the singing part, it's almost kind of like a heavier, more energetic version of POD, you know? That's just where I'm at. I don't know. Y'all disagree, maybe. Let me know, but I'm just kind of seeing, like, I'm seeing some influences in this. And I've listened to, what, 4 or 5 Eskimo Callboy tracks on the channel now? And I don't think any of them have sounded the same. I love how they can come out in every song. And I just don't know what's coming because they're so diverse. I mean, I can hear, you know, 10 or 12 different bands in the inspiration for the music. They're, man, that's awesome. I don't give a shit, so fuck that. You're making me sad. I don't give a shit. Living on a fast line, it doesn't mean I'm nothing at all. Let's fuck the scene. Ready or not, let me hear you scream. Yo, I love too, in this, it's like wild dudes screaming. You can hear like the harmony from the Cleans. And that's just kind of awesome how they're playing that. Because, you know, one thing I love, and Eskimo Callboy, you know, whether we're talking about before when they had those two singers or now with the new guy, like, I don't feel like either of the singers is trying to overshadow the other one. I feel like they're perfectly content to each play their part and kind of do what's best for the song. And you don't always get that when you have two singers. You know, you have one that does one thing, and then it's his part in the song or her part in the song, and now you've got the other one, and it's their part in the song. Man, there's something special in this. There really is. I'm ready.
Hey,
Come on! Man, this song right here, this is energetic. Like, I came, if y'all missed it, I ain't had Eskimo Callboy on the channel long. We started with Hypa, and, you know, the big thing that I loved about them with that track was the energy they were bringing, and that's what's here too. Like, they're just straight energy. It's a different kind of energy, but it's just straight energy no matter what, and all their songs are so different, man. This group's fantastic. One thing I really like too, they kind of use like rap techniques in here. Like if you listen, when it kind of mutes, they're kind of doing call outs and stuff. And you know, you see that a lot in rap. You don't see it a whole lot, but it's like, I guess where they've got the two vocalists, like one will kind of throw something out, and it's like the other one's responding, so it's like a call out and response. That's pretty fantastic to kind of see how that's worked into here. This must be the guest. This must be Fronz. Okay. I don't know who Fronz is. Y'all gonna have to let me know. I'm guessing he's a German artist. I don't know if he's a rapper or a singer or what. It sounds like he's a singer. But okay, let's go. Or both. I want to pause real quick while it's on my mind and talk about Fronz right there. Like, I really like that. It's like a more kind of guttural primal, a little bit, you know, higher pitched. If you think about what Corey Taylor was doing with Slipknot way back in the day, how he was kind of like rapping into rock, like that guy didn't break into any clean rap at all, but I mean, he was really kind of doing like a rap thing while he was screaming there. And it was kind of on that same level, except just different. You know what I mean? I'm about it. Like, I'm with it. I'm definitely down. If y'all let me know what the deal with Fronz is, y'all gotta let me know so that I can maybe check out some more Fronz, because I'm definitely about what I just saw right there. Man, hey, that track was fire right there. Like, that track had a little bit of all of it. I mean, they hit a ton of range, and it wasn't just them hitting a ton of range. Fronz was hitting a ton of range. He was kind of showing off what he could do. The track was dope. Like, the whole thing was dope. I really like, you know, it's just kind of like I don't know what point in Korn's history I'm really thinking about. I think I'm thinking about like their Untitled album, what they were doing there a lot with like, look up Liar. Look up the track Liar and tell me like the guitars there don't seem like they were kind of inspiring what was happening here. Now, I didn't love the Untitled album, just because Korn kind of strayed a little bit away from what I want Korn to be. But as an inspiration and then kind of changing it up and doing your thing with it, I'm kind of about it because I can hear shades of that in this, and I like it. I like what comes out of it. So that's all I got for this one. I appreciate you guys suggesting it to me. Let me know where we go next. Let me know if I hit up Fronz. Let me know, you know, what do you guys want? Get down in the comments. I appreciate you guys hanging out with me for a minute. I hope you guys are staying safe, taking care. I'm DJ AlphaTyler. Like the video if you enjoyed the reaction. Make sure you sub to the channel if you haven't already, especially if you keep coming back over and over. I mean, you may as well just join the Alpha team and get it over with. That's all I got today. I appreciate you guys, and I'll catch y'all next time.